who you are, dear ones, is the love. You are the light of this world. Through your creation, you may create this world anew. By realizing the love and peace within your own heart, you will create this love, sharing it with the world, bringing purification to the manifestation upon this planet. It begins with you, dear ones, by looking within yourself, by realizing who you are, by following your heart's desires, returning you back to Source. You see, dear ones, all that we believe, all that we think we know, we hold within our field of conscious creative energy. We bring forth our creative powers through our mind field, where it reverberates with our thoughts, vibrating out that which we hold within our mind as our identity. If you believe in fear, if you believe in war, then you are creating these experiences through your own energy field, through your thoughts, through your emotions. Can you understand this, dear ones? How you are the creator, and what you choose to focus upon, you create within your physical body, within your mental body, and your emotions. Change the channel, dear ones. Change the channel within yourself. Choose to focus upon the love within your heart, and you will create that love within this world. You will create the love within yourself, and as you heal your own body, your own mind, you will heal the world. For you are one piece of the whole, one part of humanity, and that which you choose to create within yourself will affect the entirety of this manifest world. You must begin at home, dear ones. You must begin to change that which lies within yourself, removing all that which is unnecessary, removing ideas of limitation, removing ideas of judgment and criticism. You must, dear ones, purify your own self. And the quickest way, dear ones, is to cast aside the illusion of the false self, to cast aside all thoughts that do not serve the unity of all that is. Cast aside these thoughts, dear ones, and focus upon your heart. For your heart has the creative power, the power of love itself, to purify all of your being, to purify your thoughts, to purify your feelings, to purify your expression, to purify your words and your actions. Become the love that you wish to share with this world by embodying that love within your heart. Embody it. Allow the love to spring forth from your heart, to spread within your body. Become the love that you desire. Can you see, dear ones, how the channels on the television, how the news within the magazines keeps you transfixed on one stream of thought, constantly creating fear and worry, anger and judgment? Can you see how the news, dear ones, keeps you fixed in creating suffering within this world through mind control, dear ones, by influencing your thoughts? Can you understand this, dear ones? Choose to turn away and choose to focus upon the love within yourself. The truth, dear ones, is within. Go within and find the truth. Be that truth and allow it to be shared through you. Without condemnation, without judgment. For the truth never judges. The truth simply is. The truth cannot change. The truth never splits apart. The truth is, dear ones. The truth is experience. The truth is unity and harmony and unconditional love. The truth is life, eternal. The truth, dear ones, is who you really are. You must, dear ones, go within and honor your heart's guidance. Your heart will lead you back to the place of purity, back to the place of unity and love. Your heart has always been there. Your heart has never left home. For your consciousness, dear ones, is birthed forth through your spiritual heart, existing here within this world, always accessible, always manifesting as the source of who you are. Yet you, dear ones, choose to focus upon your mind, thinking that your mind is the source of your being, thinking that your ideas define who you are. And so, dear ones, you put your faith and your power in thoughts of duality, in belief in a separate self, and therein lies the suffering, the wrong thinking of who you are, the ignorance of your true nature. So, dear ones, turn away, knowing that the mind is false, knowing that the mind is built up only upon ideas of separation. Turn away from your thinking mind. Turn away, dear ones, and gaze upon your heart. Understand the message of unity that comes from within yourself. Embrace the message of love that is unconditionally being shared with you each and every moment as your nurturing force. Love is life, dear ones. Without love, we die. Without love, there is no nurturing. There is no life. You must understand, dear ones, we speak of the highest principle of love. Not romantic love, not parental love, but true divine love. Life force, dear ones. Creative power, that which inspires you, that which births spirit into this material world. Love, your true self, dear ones, the pathway upon which light travels. So, dear ones, we urge you, turn off the television and turn on your heart. Look within your heart to find the truth that you know within yourself. Stop paying attention to the minds of others, to the confusion of the masses that teaches you a world of fear, that teaches you a world of separation, that teaches you to create suffering. Turn off the channels, dear one, and turn on your heart. There is no other way to the truth except within yourself. There is no other way to end suffering except by realizing yourself. You may believe the illusion and the lies that are placed before you, creating peace by inflicting war, creating unity by separating populations. You may believe these lies, dear one. Yet use your wisdom, use your discernment to see the illusion and the traps of mere words, promising unity, yet using diversity, using separation to achieve their means. How can this be, dear ones? How can unity come from separation? It is a sheer impossibility, dear ones. A sheer impossibility.